So what are the motivation factors which is actually driving HANA? So the question we need to answer here is, the business will be saying that I'm doing good with my ERP system. Why should I switch to HANA? Why should I go to the SAP S/4HANA? Why should I buy a new infrastructure? I already have so many servers with me, and I have a license agreement for next 10 years for them. Why should I scrap them and go to the SAP S/4HANA? Or what kind of problems SAP S/4HANA or HANA would be able to resolve for me, and how my business will be getting a benefits out of it? So that are the questions which business, all of the businesses are having, that how SAP S/4HANA would be helping them to increase their businesses or to solve their business issues and problems, or to give the benefits for their users to make their life simpler, or to reduce load from transaction, or to reduce the system load from the users. If these kind of things can be answered by SAP S/4HANA, or these cannot be answered by SAP S/4HANA. So that is one of the major questions which need to be answered. So to answer that question, that how business would be getting benefited from SAP S/4HANA after adopting to the new infrastructure and a new solution, and after putting so much of effort to do the conversion or to do a new implementation, what kind of benefits business would be getting? So let's discuss it here by a use case. This is just a single use case. It doesn't mean that SAP S/4HANA is coming with only these benefits. It's coming with the multiple benefits. Multiple business use cases can be answered by S/4HANA, or multiple issues can be resolved by S/4HANA, or it cannot be fully resolved, but till certain extent it would be able to help to resolve. We are just discussing here the one use case where basically the current ecosystem would not be able to support the new business scenario, and basically we need to adopt to the new technologies, new innovations to get adopted, to get our IT system adopted to the new business scenarios. So here I will quickly explain that scenario, that how this would be happening. In this use case, our use case is of a mobile company in which a user want to order a mobile, and the company has given an option here that when user is doing an order, similar like a Dell laptops, when if you have experiencing order a Dell laptop online, you can configure your laptop. The similar way you would be configure your phone, where you'd be able to put what kind of RAM should be there in phone, what kind of memory should be there, what should be the color, what kind of screen should be there, what kind of cover should be there, what kind of battery is required, what kind of headphone and charger is required. So all of these things user would be able to configure when user is putting an order. And for the delivery, the business has put it, because of the fast delivery processes and to meet the user expectation, actually user expected that the online delivery should be met next day or within the 2 to 3 days period. But business has put it a condition that within a maximum of 1 week of period, this product need to be delivered back to the consumer. That is the business scenario which business come up with. Now in this business scenario, the manufacturing of this phone is actually happening somewhere in China. The final assembly would be happening in China, and from there it would be moving to the China warehouses, to the China distribution center, shipped from China, going to the US mother warehouse, then to US distribution center, and then finally reaching at the customer end. So in this business scenario, what would be happening? We are not going to make it further longer, where basically the supply parts would be required for the phone, and that required to be ordered from the multiple vendors. So we are not making it that complex. So we are just considering that from the China, final manufacturing need to happen, and then China need to give it to the China local warehouse. From here, it need to come to the distribution center, and from the distribution center, definitely because it's a 1 week delivery, so by ship it need to be delivered, by air it need to be delivered to US mother warehouse, and from US mother warehouse it need to come to the local distribution center, and from the local distribution center it need to be delivered to the final consumer. So this chain looks long, but kind of operations we have, kind of the improvement in the operations, kind of the improvements we have in the logistics processes. Business come back and saying that the functional operations would be possible to deliver these products within a week, to get it manufactured from the China plant, delivered to the different warehouses, and actually getting it delivered to the final customer is still possible within the 1 week. So that comes from the functional operations. But that is the functional operations. We need to also add the lead time from the IT ecosystem. So the IT ecosystem need to also analyze whether they would be able to support these kind of new business scenario, or what would be their lead time in this whole process. And when you add their lead time, whether you will be able to fulfill these kind of business scenarios or not. So what happened from the IT side? So if I draw the IT picture here, from the IT side, once the sales order has been created from here, it's punched, the sales order will be punched into this distribution center. From this distribution center, the requirement need to go first to the main warehouse or mother warehouse. The requirement need to go, and the how the requirement will be flowing from this distribution center to the mother warehouse is generally we have internal MRP runs. With the help of MRP run, it will be flowing, or you can also have some kind of cases. You can also have your APO runs. You can have your heuristic runs, or you can have your PPDS runs. So there would be a batch jobs would be available which need to run, and sometime it would be the multiple batch jobs. First you will be running a APO batch job, and post APO batch job you will be running your MRP batch jobs. Now in the current system, the problem with this batch jobs is this lady has put it to order in 6 a.m. in the morning. So the next batch job scheduled with MRP run is at night 11 p.m. and it will take 3 to 4 hours, and it will be giving results around 3 a.m. So the requirement transfer which need to happen from one plant to another plant to another plant, that requirement transfer itself will take almost 24 hours of time. So the first requirement transfer will take 24 hours. One day of the time would be eaten by IT system itself, because due to the system performance issues and due to the all other constraints, you don't run the regular MRPs. You run an MRP once in a day, and that is also in the night batch job run. And then your requirements will be transferred once the MRP runs get completed. And then if you will take the total lead time, would be around 24 hours. This can be even more if you want to execute an APO run, which can take a longer 7 to 8 hours. And following the APO runs, you need to run an MRP run. Then MRP run need to give you the final picture. So if that kind of cases are there, the time taken is more longer. Then you need something to move from this US mother warehouse to move to the distribution center. It can happen with the same MRP run with the access sequence or with the scope of run. It can happen that once this MRP run has happened at the US mother warehouse, then the MRP run can happen at the distribution center level. Or some kind of cases, the things are more complex. where you have a separate instances. You have a US regional system. Then you have a China regional system. Two separate boxes you are having. When you have a two separate boxes, then again you need something to interact. Either you put some middleware or you put some kind of integration between both, which will be actually taking all of the requirements from here and passing it ahead once the MRP run is done at the source plant. So that thing also can be done with another batch job, which will be transferring the requirement from one instance to the another instance or from one box to another box. Then again, you can have a different batch jobs with the different timings to transfer your requirement from the distribution center to the local warehouse and then to the final plant. So in this whole of this process to transfer the requirement only, actually the 2 days can be consumed. Some kind of cases it can be also 3 days, but 2 days can be consumed just to transfer the requirement. And we are talking the most kind of cases where the MRP run happen every day at the night job. There are some companies who even run MRPs once in a week. There are very, very exceptional scenarios where some companies run MRP once in a month, although it's very exceptional, but still exists in some of the companies. So what would be happening? The time lag which you are giving to transfer your requirement is actually adding into your lead time. And that lead time, adding into the lead time, is because of the IT ecosystem, because you don't have any system which actually run your MRP every 15 minutes or real time, or every 1 hour MRP can run happen. So that kind of systems you don't have. Because of this issue, you are putting a batch job in a night run. And due to this night run batch job, what would be happening? You would be having a delay in your processes. And after doing so many things, after doing even after spending this 1 day of the time, also you would not be having a realistic picture, because once the SAP MRP results come at 3 a.m. then let's say the order got cancelled at 7 a.m. okay, or you have another return comes, so another order got cancelled or extra delivery came up in this warehouse which is exactly meeting the customer requirement. Okay, so still your MRP will be generating a requirement to the manufacturing plant, and manufacturing plant would be still be updating. The next update would be going to the manufacturing plant in the next day morning. Until and unless there are manual interventions in between. So this is the one side of the flow where basically you have seen the one side of the flow also has been taken time. And when we talk about the other side of the flow with the help of IT ecosystems, the other steps also, you would be having multiple things to run to deliver it from one step to another step with the IT systems. Again, to deliver it, to send it from one instance to another instance, either you would be sending it through IDOCS, or if IDOCS is there, it can go immediately. Or if some batch jobs are there, then also you will be having some delays here. And for the final deliveries also, or for any deliveries at any point, whether in the China or in the US, you also have some kind of batch jobs. You do a batch jobs to confirm schedule lines. Then you have a batch job for your back order processing. In some cases, the back order processing, or you have a batch job for delivery creation. In some cases, we have seen even this batch jobs also happens once in a day. Your back order processing, which confirm your schedule lines, or your delivery creation also happens once in a day or twice in a day, which means that even your materials are ready at 6 a.m. or 9 a.m. in the morning, and your next batch job for the delivery creation is 1 p.m. it need to wait for the 5 hours. Okay, so because of all of these things, you can see here that a lot of time has been consumed by the IT ecosystem. So now the question comes that these all times if we want to reduce, how we can reduce it. So SAP has done a lot of research on that. They were getting these all kind of business scenarios and business issues and problems getting together from the multiple places. And SAP understood one thing, that these questions or these queries or the advanced business processes which is coming up in future cannot be addressed only by writing a new codes or writing new